Good morning, my name is Sean Robertson and I'm Sales Director here at Sunseeker International. And today I wanted to give you a good run through of a brand new exciting model, the Predator 55 EVO. Now, I thought we'd start outside today looking at a key feature of any Sunseeker, let alone the Predator range, which is the hull. So still with a very deep V, hard chine hull, progressive dead rise all the way through to ensure that she runs exceptionally well into a sea, into a head sea, in a following sea, and then warped V aft, which gives the a good amount of lift to make sure that she can really carry the weight of toys, tenders, and everything you want on board really well. One of the key changes on the Pred 55 EVO from the existing Predator 50 is that performance, that all-important engine power. Because we're changing from the 600 horsepower Volvos, the D8s, all the way through to the D11 725s. Now that's a 250 horsepower change, but a bigger block, more torque, and a much more flexible performance for the client to use. So, should be much better at that cruising range, still a great top end performance when you really want to get home back to that marina first. And really just changing the flexibility of use that you find in the Predator 50 currently. The other key changes, I think a lot, we can see here on what is the Predator 60 EVO, but has the very similar external changes, and we can run through these now for you. So firstly, you'll notice the detailing. So on the hull windows, for example, you'll see this stainless steel insert between the glazing. Small details, but make a dramatic change in the overall look of the exterior. And if we just go up these stairs here, we'll give you a couple of other key features. Firstly, on that side view, the air intake, obviously very important, not just feature, but obviously technically for the engine room. But you'll notice now going to the carbon fiber and stainless steel finish. Again, makes a dramatic change on the overall exterior image. And then a practical feature. On the bow rails, you'll see that rather than having the mid section of that rail in wire, that it does go to a beautiful stainless steel tube all the way aft, right the way around to the forward end of the pulpit. So that gives us a good overview of the exterior changes. But let's go back into the office now. We'll get the GA out and we'll run through all the interior layout and design changes on the Predator 55 EVO. So, as we said outside, let's have a good look at the GA now to really understand what the interior layout and design is on the Pred 55. So firstly, if we look to the outside, you can see all those detailing we were talking about really brings a great silhouette overall look to the 55. Really has, I think, really enhanced the look over the Predator 50. So let's start at the stern. So what you get is obviously the full hydraulic bathing platform, then leading to a garage with, you know, which can accommodate up to a 325 Williams jet rib. So a great size in the garage and still space for extra equipment in the way of paddle boards, anything in that way, sea bobs, you can accommodate in the garage space and obviously launch very easily from the platform. Going forward into the cockpit, this is probably one area where I think there's been a dramatic change from the Predator 50, where you've really gained in this aft cockpit space. So you've got opposing seating forward and aft. To give you an idea, we're gaining about 400 mil, so about half a meter, you know, just under half a meter in this aft cockpit space. Still a great table which can either be folded more casual or then folded out to give a dining area. And this really, I think, just really accentuates, makes much better use of that aft cockpit. If we go forward from there, the main saloon area, the first thing that will hit you is the changes that we first made last year on the Predator 60 EVO, which is this complete design change. Very sculpted, low slung furniture, a real move forward in that overall look of the interior. Discrete lighting, feature stainless steel strip inserts on the cabinetry, but not losing any of the feature that we had before. So you're still keeping that fantastic carbon fiber hardtop. And you've got to remember in this boat, when you open that hard top back, have the door open. So remember, this main panel swings up, the companion door swings open. You've virtually got an open Predator. I mean, you're looking all the way through to the windscreen uninterrupted and having at least 50% of this internal space open to the sky as well with the carbon fiber top. Great news is even when it's closed with the glazing in the top, the windshield and the full glazing down both sides, the overside glazing on the hull sides, you still don't feel like you're, you know, in a really tight inner space. It's great light, great visibility. Another big change is the console area. So we've really tried to accentuate that feeling of being in a sports environment, ergonomically improved, so everything feels, you know, falls the hand very easily. Incorporating a lot of the control systems into touch panels, and just overall a much better, more ergonomic feeling console space that when you're sat there, everything to hand, beautiful to look at, and much, much easier to use. Opposite, still a great seating area. I mean, when you're running, obviously two people at the helm, and then easily one or two people in this area opposite that's raised as well. So you've got a great visibility forward through the screen. Very important when you're running. If we go then, before we go downstairs, I think the next bit is worth noting, so that this boat is a down galley. So the galley is down, but because of this huge opening over that saloon space that runs forward, the amount of natural light you're getting onto the lower deck is fantastic. So it really, really sort of joins the spaces together. Although it's on a lower level, it feels part of that main flow through the main saloon and into galley saloon space on the lower deck. So down a beautiful set of teak stairs, you come into this lower saloon space. It's set up with a great size galley that can accommodate dishwasher, lots of overhead and main cupboard space. Really usable. There's an option of two bar stools if you feel like having that on this almost sort of breakfast bar area. Opposite that, we have a lower saloon. Great seating, TV, table, which can, as an option, be infilled with a bulkhead and become a third cabin. So very, very flexible on that lower deck layout. Going aft from the saloon, down one step, you come into what is a full beam master cabin. Great layout choices in terms of storage or seating on the starboard side, and a really good size ensuite on the port side here. The overriding feeling though in this cabin is A, the height. You know, a lot of Predator sport style boats, when you get into the lower deck, can feel quite closed in on because of the headroom. You don't feel that on the Pred 50. 2 meters plus feels really a good size cabin that you'd expect to find on a much larger boat. And of course the hull windows, you can see the glazing here on the hull side, that translates directly into the master cabin. So a great amount of natural light coming into that cabin space. The forward VIP, scissor berths. So again, you've got great functionality if you've got children maybe staying in the cabin who want their own separate beds, swung apart in the outer position, works extremely well. Or you're bringing guests, family on board that want the double, they simply scissor together, clip together, and then you've got a great size double bed in that forward VIP. Ensuite, which also has a second doorway to act as the day head, you know, whilst you're using the boat during the day. And we shouldn't forget that even in that forward cabin, with the amount of glazing in the hull, you know, again, the natural light, overhead, double skylight and hatch in the deck, you know, again, although you're in the bow of the boat, the feeling of light, the height in the cabin, the feeling of spaciousness is great. I mean, it really works exceptionally well. So the overriding change though with the EVO designation now to these new models is the feature within those cabins. So all the way through the design, from the saloon, all the way through the lower decks, not only is the cabinetry changed in its look really bringing it a step forward. The detailing into the bulkheads, into the doors, into the headboard panelling, for instance, in the master cabin, is quite unique and really something that we've not ever done before. So this EVO look continues what is, you know, probably the start of a family from the Predator 60, now with the Predator 55, giving you a very distinctive, very special feel to this EVO generation, new generation of boats. So I hope that gives you a very good look through on the changes externally and internally. Overall length, we're just over 55 feet. Obviously with the engine change, it's giving you performance up to about 32, 33 knots, a range of well over 200 miles. Any questions, please don't hesitate to contact your local dealer or us directly, and we hope to see you in the Sunseeker family very soon. Thank you very much.